Hi, I'm Don with AWS.
And I'm David with Vercara, and this is my architecture.
So David, what I think I'm looking at is a very scalable architecture for basically transforming, aggregating, and providing a query mechanism based on edge network data. Can you walk us through that, the architecture from the edge?
Sure, sure.
Awesome.
At Vercara, our edge network for DNS resolvers spans the entire globe. Throughout the day, we receive roughly 530 billion unique transactions.
Wow, that's an impressive number.
Through that generates a lot of exhaust data that we need to take internally to process so we can report on it, mm-hmm. things of that nature. So at the every single edge location, they generate multiple files per minute, containing that data in a proprietary compressed format to send us that information. Throughout the day, it's upwards of 400,000 unique files that we receive.
Okay.
And upwards of 20 terabytes of compressed data per day that we need to ingest into our warehouse.
How many records would you say per second that you process?
It comes out to be roughly 6.6 million records per second. We have lows of around 2 million, upwards to 10 million per second.
Okay, wow. All right, I'm excited now.
Yep. So from the edge, as they upload each file, it goes to an ingest bucket into S3, where we have notifications set up, which traverse through SNS and then over to SQS for our transformers to receive those files.
Mm-hmm.
What the transformers do is they take the single compressed file from our edge and converts it into something that we can actually directly query and interact with. So as the transformers pick up files or the notifications from SQS, they grab the files from our ingest bucket, process through the file. Mm-hmm. It enhances the data, extracts the information, and outputs a Parquet file, which then uploads into our first official S3 warehouse bucket location.
I have to imagine that you didn't start with S3. Maybe you started with a database.
Correct.
And then also just like, did you find that you had so much data that you were trying to process that you basically reached the limits?
Correct. In the past, we've used Redshift. We've used Postgres compliant databases to store this information. And as the company has grown over time, obviously the amount of DNS traffic has increased.
Mm-hmm.
So previously we've kind of outgrown a lot of the solutions.
Okay.
In addition to that, the more our usage of the data has increased as well, more reporting, more analytics, things of that nature.
Okay. So why don't we look at the aggregation here? I'm curious about what you're having to aggregate and why.
So the information that comes in from the edge is at microsecond level precision, being over 530 billion records per day.
Mm-hmm.
That's an awful lot of data to scan and attempt to make queries off of. What we end up doing is we can take that data from microsecond and we go into various other levels, like minute, hour, day. As a file enters our warehouse into the raw, we send another notification over to SNS.
Okay.
It's picked up here. And then our aggregators interact with the ingestion of that raw data going into the warehouse itself. So it'll web out its various operations into the different tables that we serve up with glue for our warehouse infrastructure.
Got it. So David, I have to imagine that there are benefits to consumers on the far right over there, as well as some operational benefits. You want to talk about those?
Correct. So internally, we have consumers with reports, but we also mm-hmm. have an API available to our customers.
Okay.
Throughout the day, we have thousands upon thousands of queries against our data. With our consumers using Athena, which then hit the warehouse itself,
mm-hmm.
The power of isolation between the queries execution, where they no longer impact each other, is a major benefit that we had.
Okay.
Previous solutions that we've used, one wrong query that hits a database would impact 100% of our users. Yeah. This completely eliminates that. The other added benefit to this warehouse solution is the time to which the data becomes available.
Okay.
With our transformer and the first minute operations that we have, it takes roughly 4 to 5 minutes from data on the wire at the edge to appear in the warehouse in a queryable fashion.
Got it. And what about cost? I mean, it looks like, especially using S3, has to be some cost benefits.
Oh, absolutely. With the data that we receive, every table that we have is a different S3 location, mm-hmm. sort of behind the scenes. So with using S3 lifecycle rules, we're able to kind of fine tune the exact amount of data for each table type that we have. So some of the higher level aggregations like Minute, which are very large in size, we can cut that off early and okay. save money.
Wow, this is very impressive. The numbers, the sheer amount of records per second that you mentioned earlier, and as well as the simplicity of what you've created is very impressive. So thank you very much, David, for sharing that with us.
Thank you.